Dad always says the pack stays together.
That's my girl.
Now we're searching for a perfect place to call home.
What the heck is that?
It's the end of the world.
Dun, dun, dun.
Well, that's it for me. I'm glad it's you, Chunky.
I loved the movie. It's so good. I watch a lot of movies, as you probably know. I mean, I'm watching like several movies a week or whatever during these interviews, but I really love this one.
That makes me very happy. You know,
because it has a lot of humor, but it also had heart. And I'm going to admit something to you. Maybe this is cheesy, but I cried. I even cried.
Really? Maybe you don't want to give any giveaways, but I was curious which part got you.
Well, I'm a parent. I have two kids. I mean, they're little, so it's like not exactly like the same situation, but I don't know. I guess it's just, I think it was probably, I can't remember the exact part, but I think it was probably Greg, like, you know, having to give away his child. And
I love making a movie about family. Because it's everybody has a way in when watching it. And I have three younger kids, and you know, you want to watch something as a parent that they're going to enjoy, it's appropriate for them, but also as that is not just watered down and aged down to where, you know, as a parent, you can't enjoy it. So that was the goal, is like, let's have an entry point for everybody to go on this journey with.
Yeah, I was kind of looking at your past, obviously, like your bio and everything, and it says that you've done a lot of family movies. Is that kind of your passion that you want to continue doing, animated and family films?
Yeah, you know, I love animation. I love it because you can you create something out of nothing. There's no world, there's no characters, and you create these fictional worlds that feel so real and actually can transport audiences into kind of empathizing with these characters and going on a real journey with them, a real message that comes from it.
Who's your, because I saw myself in it. Who did you see? Who are you?
Well, you know, obviously as a father, I definitely relate to Grug in some ways, but the thing that may surprise you is I relate to Eep a lot. she has this excitement for the world, and especially as a kid, I was very rambunctious, got into trouble a lot, but also, you know, really like had this excitement for everything. And so she's the one I'd say I connect to the most.
No, I love that. She has like a really adventurous spirit. So I love that. And, you know, I think there's a beautiful like father-daughter relationship. Obviously, like that's one of the big themes in it. So can you kind of talk about that theme a little bit more?
Yeah, you know, the beauty of the first movie, it's a beautiful father-daughter story. And I really wanted to continue where we left off with this family. And where we left off was Grug, you know, had a hard time with accepting Guy into his pack, but he's now Guy's part of the pack. And maybe the Grug's not ready for the next step in his daughter's life, which is she's growing up. She's ready to leave the pack and start a home of her own, which is just hard for any father. And it's really a story about change of, you know, not only the father going through that, but also these young adults going, okay, they're experiencing what love means and what freedom means. And so that was really the goal in this.
Well, it's even kind of cute because it looks a little bit like, you know, they're actually saying I do, which is like actually like they're getting married or whatever. It's funny because you have the two looking at each other and then the father in the back. And so it's kind of how like it's structured in a wedding. Or was that kind of how it how it worked out? Or?
Well, we wanted that kind of feel of like, this is the world's first, it was a proposal / wedding kind of thing, especially giving a rock. maybe they didn't figure out diamonds are a cool rock yet. But that it has that feel. And that's the fun of like the world's first time this happened. And yeah, definitely that was the intent.
You know, I think one of the fun things about the Croods and like with the first one, is in this one is like they have really clever creatures and stuff that are kind of popping up all over the place. Now that was probably pretty fun to kind of arrange and stuff.
Oh yeah. We've got like boards full of like the art department did like hundreds of creatures that like, here's a combo. And the hardest part was going, okay, we can't put all of these in the movie and picking the ones that best supported the story. But I'm really happy with the ones that ended up in there.
Yeah, no, they're super fun characters. You should make the cat into some kind of plush doll or a plush animal or something. What's
right? What's so Chunky, actually, look, there he is back there. he's called a macanivore, which is a macaw and a saber-tooth tiger mixed together. And we brought him over. It was fun to bring have returning creatures from the first one, like Belt and Chunky. And then to introduce them to, like, Sash is a new the counterpart of Belt. She's also an accessory and another sloth, but she's very pink.
Yeah. And what about the new kind of, the Bettermans are in this like new house and this new place. What was kind of the imagination there when you guys were making that kind of?
You know, we want it to be like somewhere where you go, oh, I want to be there. Like, it's like a resort-like. You're like, oh, it's amazing. But underneath that story is, it's a story about like the power of family. And the cool thing was, at first glance, the Bettermans, they live behind this giant wall. They're safe. It looks like paradise. They have a tree house. They have little huts in. But in doing so, in embracing modern technology, they've kind of lost that family connection with each other. They built walls in between each other. And the wonderful thing about the Croods is they have nothing. They only have each other. And actually, that's why I love this painting. It was one of the first ones we did. And it's the Croods sleeping in a giant pile in the cold desert, but there's this warmth that comes from them. And that's what's underneath this story is the power of family and the power of actually expanding that definition of family.
Yeah, I love that because, you know, the materials don't matter. It doesn't matter, you know, how many things you have. It's all about the family, really.
Yeah. And it's funny how this theme of connection and disconnection has become even more relevant over the 3 years we've been making this. Like, we're having our conversation now, you know, through the computer, through technology, which is not necessarily a bad thing. It's great that we can do this, but I think we all feel this. Humans are pack animals. We want to be together. And that's what I feel is very relevant in this story.
Oh yeah. Especially this year, thinking about it with COVID and kind of the restrictions and stuff. And you know, we want everybody to be safe, but you know, people long to be with other people and everything. So.
Yeah. I think it's made us appreciate when we were able to be with each other. So, you know, want everybody to be safe. And also when we get on the other side of this thing, it'll make those occasions even more joyous, I feel like.
Yeah. Now my father there's a lot of grog in my father, I feel like, because this idea of like the family together, the family pack, the family this, it just reminded me so much about that because it's like, he's the one that keeps everybody like at all times, we all have to be together. I actually ended up working for him, so I guess that worked.
That's awesome.
So it really reminded me of that. You know, the Croods has this kind of theme about like the light, and our organization actually is a faith organization. So I kind of see the light as kind of a faith thing, but what was the intention with, you know, striving to look towards the light?
Yeah. You know, light in the first Croods was this kind of was the goal, right? Was them like surviving this crazy world. Yeah. And we continue that in here. Light is a representation of hope. And in this movie in particular, that light comes from these people and realizing essentially all their differences aside, their future is brighter when it's shared with each other. And that's in this one, that's what light represents.
I love that. And are there certain movies that you like to make that you see your kids in or that you want your kids to see? I don't know what the age group of your kids are, but.
Yeah, my daughter's 7, 10, and then I have a 12-year-old boy. You know, and this is in making this, I take into account not just my kids, but, you know, kids all over the world who are like experiencing characters. One of the big choices we made in this was we didn't want the two female characters, the teenagers, when they first meet, we didn't want that to be the classic trope of jealousy, of cattiness, of negativity. We wanted this to be like, I think the reality is when these two, like when Eep, who's been traveling the world with her family, no other teenagers, and comes across Dawn, who lives behind a wall, sees another teenager, their first thing is, I have a new best friend. And that decision is one that I'm really proud of, because when my daughters watch the movie, they don't see these girls talking about guys and being jealous. They see two best friends actually treated much the same way we treat boys in comedies, where it's funny to watch them, you know, yeah, kind of be idiots together and make the same choices. And so that friendship is one that I'm really happy we made that choice with.
Oh, I really appreciated that. I loved that aspect, because you thought, like, at first it was going to go one way and then it went a different way. And it was a much better way that they were friends and they were like helping each other kind of learn from the situation or grow or whatever. So that was a really well played moment.
I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Well, as you can tell, I really enjoyed it. And I want to thank you for your time and everything. And actually, we gave the first Croods awards. We have the Movie Guide Awards. So this one's up for consideration too, because it
has— Oh, that makes me happy. You know, it's been a joy to work on this movie, even despite the crazy 2020 and all the challenges. When you're surrounded by, like, we have an amazing team of over 300 people who just have the most positive attitudes. And that joy, I feel like we were able to infuse into the movie, so that hopefully that people can enjoy this movie and it could bring some laughter into the world right now.
What's that?
Kill circle. Today is a good day to die.
Hey, everyone, you'll never guess what I found out.
Sorry, honey. We thought you were a predator trying to kill us.
No, never apologize for an effective kill circle.